Welcome back, guys. We're all hooked up, ready to get away for the weekend. This weekend we're headed out to Costa Nova, KOA, on the coast of California between Half Moon Bay and Santa Cruz. Let's come along for the ride. So we're here backing up. I'm using this Levelmate Pro. I'm gonna give you guys a full review on this another time. This app is amazing. I'm leveling your trailer when you first get to the campsite. So. How's it going?
How are you?
Good, good. Yeah. Can't complain, right?
Right?
So here we are, here's the two sites for us this weekend.
Hi!
Got a big old field out here in the middle. This loop is the best loop to get if you come here. The only ones that have concrete, everything else is all dirt. But you also get this big field to play in. What's the name of this hose again? It's what? The Camco Evo Flow. One of the best hoses. It's not stiff. Easy to maneuver. So this is what's going to be for dinner. 11.5 pound pork shoulder. We're gonna smoke it for 7 hours and see how it turns out. So there we go. We'll see how this turns out in 7.5 hours. We're using the Green Mountain Grills Davy Crockett camping smoker. Only the second time that I've actually really got to use this thing. So I'm still trying to learn a little bit. It comes with a nice app that you can control the temperature from your phone. You can set the temperature that you want to cook at, set alarms. It's actually a really nice smoker. Runs off either 120, 12 volt, a battery. Comes with all the connections.
Whatever it is.
That's pretty cool, huh?
You're in my seatbelt, Abigail. We going to the beach. Say hi. Hi.
Hi.
I just got there.
leave it. Whoa! There we go. We're at the beach.
It's all over.
It's not hot there.
Fine. Fine.
No, it isn't. It's a shell.
Oh.
Let's see. Yeah, it's an old. No, it's part of a. It's like, part of a crab or something.
It looks
like
it's a
we got, I think, four different loops here. You got eucalyptus loop, which is just your basic back end, small dirt sites. Not a whole lot to them. Table. And then you got the next one down, which is your whales north, which I believe is your pull-throughs. Yes, it's your pull-throughs, so you can pull through for ease of not having to back up and things like that. But again, they are kind of small. You get a table, little freestanding fire pit, not a whole lot of room. I see that more as your bigger motor homes and things like that. But on the eucalyptus loop, as you can see back there, you get a little patio with your rent of the site. And then as we go down, I feel they get better and better as you go down all the way to the end, which sites that we're in, where you have a nice paved spot to park your trailer and truck. You get a paver style patio. Comes with a nice center block fire pit. They also provide you with an actual two burner Weber grill, which is nice. Use their propane. This next one is a mix of sites and cabins. That's your coastal village. Again, sites aren't terribly big, but you do get a little deck patio in the back, so you do get a little bit more room. Down towards the end, they have better cabins that are newer, bigger. And of course, here's the park, right centrally located, right next to the Pine Tent, which is a bar, pizza oven, restaurant that opens up at 4 on the weekends. Then you got your rec center, which they do tie-dye bingo. Some more cabins back there. And then you get this Seascape South, which is the loop that we're in. So you get the big meadow, like I've said before. Big area for the kids to play, run your dogs. But the campsites, I feel, are just way better. A lot more roomier. You have more room for your slides. You have more room for sitting out. You got a nice deck, patio. So, that's where we try to stay when we come here all the time, is this loop. We prefer it better. But honestly, anything here, if you can get it, because this place is so popular, it's hard to book. So any site here actually would be worth it.
Which one was it?
I'll take Colonel
Wilson. Can I see? Just make sure. Yeah, you can put your shirt right down there. Did you do the other side?
Yes.
Okay.
Can we unwrap it right now?
Yeah, just take off the rubber bands.
More color.
Okay, Abby Dab, so we're going to put them on our
the center might
on the little dots.
You can do on both sides?
Not that color.
Both sides.
Okay.
Thank you.
Because
so
I couldn't really get the center, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. This will be my first shirt from here.
Whoa. Look at that. That's beautiful. Oh. Both of you. Great job.
I want to know how you did that.
Great
That's
job.
Cool.
Mommy,
can I get your mom?
Stick around, Amanda. Mom.
It's a big paintball fight.
Looks cool. Good.
Okay. This shit is happening.
Okay, Mom.
Travis is legit singing through.
Through the radio?
Singing through this.
Okay, yeah. Come around here.
So I got you.
First of all, where are we?
We are at Costa Nova.
You have to look into the camera and say it.
We're at Costa Nova.
So we came to Costa Nova because we were able to get a reservation, and this is one of our
favorite places.
Favorite places. And why is it our favorite?
Because it's nice and it's next to the beach, and we can drive to the beach or we can walk to the beach, and it's just a beautiful, quiet place.
Absolutely, one of the prettiest places we've ever been. The trees are beautiful, and so because we thought it was so beautiful and we wanted to share that with somebody, we bought our friend Travis. Right?
P.S. We also brought him because his mom's birthday is today.
And who's his mom?
Brooke.
Yep. So Brooke and Travis got to come with us and be part of our... Come on, Brooke. Come and say hi.
Come say hi.
This is Brooke's... this is Travis's birthday. Mom, Brooke. Everybody say hi.
Hi, guys. Thank you for having us come on.
Oh, it wasn't your my invitation.
Favorite place.
But you can come anytime.
This is my favorite really place now.
I'm invited to my birthday.
Okay, so we're getting started now. So we're at Costa Nova. And where is, do you guys know where Costa Nova is?
By the coast.
It is by the coast. So we live, it's above Santa Cruz, yes. So it's between Santa Cruz and Half Moon Bay. And it's right almost in the middle, a little farther, closer to Santa Cruz. We're on the coast, yeah, we already established that. So at Costa Nova, there's all kinds of cool things to do here. So what is one of the, well, first of all, what date were we here?
We got 3-4-23. Yeah, because today's the 6th.
And then we're staying, we're leaving on 3-6, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
2022.
All right, so do we know what our campground numbers are? Are they
on? SO2 and SO1.
Okay. So SO1 and SO2. And that's because we have two trailers with us, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Your trailer and our trailer.
Thank you for that. Okay, so how was the weather? It was kind of different this time, huh?
It was cold. Yeah.
It was super cold, but that's because it's March.
It got cold, and then it got a little bit warm sometimes, and it wasn't that windy every single day.
So the first day we got here was pretty darn windy.
Yes.
Windy, yeah. And it was pretty cold, and it got really cold at night. So we're going to circle cloudy. It was a little cloudy because the clouds were swirling around.
Yeah, and there was rainy.
And it was a lot of wind.
And there was rain, and then there was sunny. Slightly cloudy.
So almost everything except snow we got here.
Yeah,
huh?
And it's sunny today.
So today is a beautiful day though, huh?
Yeah,
it's really cold. Pretty. The weather, yeah, it's a little chilly because it's a little breezy, but it's not like it was the first day we got here.
No.
Yeah.
So if you're gonna come here, probably don't come in March. That's what we're saying.
Or when there's a storm.
Okay, so we're gonna put in here that Travis and his mom came for her birthday, and his mom is
Brooke. 36 years old.
Okay.
We can't see ya.
What?
We don't talk about we don't talk about Bruno, but we also don't talk about age. So.
Bro.
Okay, chill out.
She's not 36. Not 36.
How old are you, Brooke?
She's 32.
32. I was gonna say 24, but okay, we'll say 32.
What?
Okay. So first of all.
And 9.
Okay, are you paying attention? Because we're doing this. All right, we're doing this without you.
Madison.
And 9.
And how old are you?
9.
9, okay. Well, Travis is 9, but it's not his birthday. Okay. All right, so this time we're going to start things a little bit differently than we have before because we're going to talk about... Are you paying attention?
We don't talk about Bruno.
Okay, well, we're not talking about Bruno. We're talking about something that we think is really important when we come camping now. We're going to start this every camping trip, and what is that?
Cleaning up and taking care of the area.
Okay, you need to calm down or we're going to stop. Okay, what's the thing that we just talked about? What is the one thing
take
we're going to do?
No, make it better as you saw it.
That's right. So we are going to make sure that our campground looks better when we leave than it did when we got here, right?
Yep.
So what are we going to do about that?
Pick up trash.
We're gonna pick up trash, but not big trash, because we always put that in the trash can. But what kind of trash are we gonna pick up?
Little scraps and little beer cans.
Candy pieces.
Cans. Like our little
Capri
Sun wrappers.
Yep. The little wrappers from the straws and little pieces of tinsel from somebody who might have had a birthday party here. And why are we gonna do that?
So the birds and the animals don't get sick or die.
Right, because they pick it up and they think it's food sometimes and fun stuff. Sometimes
like
they
little,
make
like,
nests with it. Yeah, little pieces of paper because it's not part of their environment, is it?
No.
What do we have here? What do we see? We see dirt and grass
bushes, and trees.
That's their environment, right? It's not our garbage that they need to have. So we're going to do that every trip now. We're going to start with something like that, okay? So how many pieces of garbage did you pick up this morning?
30.
30 pieces. What did you pick up?
10.
I picked up 13.
Yeah, because you're into odd numbers. So if with all those pieces of garbage, imagine if every single person had tons of garbage like that, there'd be a lot of garbage here, right?
Yeah.
So we're going to take care of our space and we're going to do the right thing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, great. All right, so let's talk about our memories. Let's talk about the best thing about coming camping. We'll start with Travis.
The best thing for coming here at camping is doing tie-dye and seeing the, going to the beach.
Yeah.
And then seeing the seal.
The elephant seal. Okay, so we're going to go back to that because those are really important things that we're going to write down. What about you, Maddie?
I'm not sure. Everything was my favorite memory.
Well, come up with one thing that was the best thing you did.
Pick up crabs, little like crab.
Oh, arms. The stuff you collected at the beach.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then seeing this elephant seal.
Yeah, I think that
named
was pretty
Bob.
Cool.
Yeah, and then I named him Bob.
And we named him Bob. Yeah, that's
and
right.
His eyes
and
red.
Every time I would say bye, Bob, his eyes would open and stare at me like, leave me alone.
Okay, well, we're going to go back to that, too. But what is your favorite thing, Abigail?
I have nothing.
You mean the chocolate cake that we made for Auntie's birthday was pretty cool?
It was cold.
It was cold because it was cold outside. But we had a chocolate cake with white frosting and a lot of candles. Probably more than our birthday candles, huh?
No, that is 17 candles.
We had 17 candles.
Holy!
So she got really lucky. Okay, what was our best camping food? What was your favorite food, Abby?
Eggs and bacon.
Eggs and bacon, mine too.
And the blueberry thing.
Oh, yeah, I brought blueberry coffee cake, didn't
yes,
I?
Yes, okay. I liked that.
Coffee
now
cake.
My eyes.
That's then sit upright and you won't have that problem. Come on, you're blowing my deal here. Come on, I won't do this
sweater.
If you're gonna mess around. What was your favorite?
I think the mac and cheese on the
The mac and cheese on the first night?
Oh yeah. And the other thing? I don't remember.
The other thing.
I like the blueberry coffee cake.
What was it?
Hamburgers?
Yes.
Oh,
hot
you.
Dog. I had a hot dog.
You know what you liked? You liked the Chipotle mayonnaise. That was your favorite
yes.
thing.
Yes.
Yeah. Mayo. And Maddie liked the blueberry coffee cake.
Yep.
Okay, so I wanted to talk about Costa Nova because it's a pretty cool place, but would we say that it was not great, average, good, or amazing?
Amazing.
Yeah,
change
I agree.
Coke.
I agree. I think amazing is definitely the key here because this place is awesome, isn't it? So when we came here the first time, we got to do a lot of stuff, and it was really, really nice weather.
Yes.
But we got to do almost the same stuff this time, too.
Yeah, besides the bingo. We didn't
okay.
get to do the
yeah,
bingo.
That's right. We didn't. So they have in
and
the center.
Horses.
They have. Oh, they took the horses out a while ago. I think that's something else. So here, where your campground is, because we stay in the really nice spots, but they're all really nice.
Yeah.
There's a place in the middle where they have a big area where you can play, what's that game? Connect?
Connect Four. And Cornhole.
So they have a big Connect Four area.
And they have a big
cornhole.
Chest.
Oh, they have a huge chest.
Yes.
Huge chest.
By the general store.
By the general store.
And the general store. There's two places that have like...
And they have a very cool restaurant. And we didn't eat there because we made our own food, but we've been there before and they have really good food. And for the adults, they have really good drinks.
Mm-hmm.
Full
I know they
bar,
like,
the whole thing.
I know my mom liked the beer.
Okay. So, stand up. This is your deal.
All you can say is the bar here is good.
I did. I said the bar was excellent. And they let you take them to your campsite, which is even better. But then there's a little bar over there in the middle where they have all
pine,
the other
pine
things.
Top
pine Top Bar.
And they had music going.
Oh, and they had a band last night. On Saturday night, they had a band. And I think they had a band last time we were here, too.
Yeah, they played over on the stage.
And they have a really cool area by the restaurant. So basically, the campground is owned by KOA. And just as you come into the campground, there's a space where there's the hotel and a restaurant. It's not really a hotel, but it kind of, I think, is. A spa, and then they have a general store, which is very cool. They sell a lot of organic things in the general store. It's a little village, yeah. And then they have lots of cool things to buy because Travis got his mom a really cool bracelet for her birthday. And we got stickers and some other stuff. Okay, so what else did we have? So we did a tie-dye. So on Saturday between 1 and 3, I think it was?
Yes.
They did tie-dye t-shirts and they
no,
help you?
No, 1 through 4.
Oh, okay.
No.
Okay. they do really, really cool tie-dye stuff.
Yeah.
And they help you tie them all up, and then you choose your colors and make super cool shirts. Okay, Abby, whatever. So then, what else do they do here? There's lots of trails. There's lots of hiking.
Yeah. There's ramps, dog parks.
Oh, yeah, the dog park's right down there. And then you can see the beach from every campsite, right? I'm looking right over there, and the beach is right there, and it's really, really
pretty. It looks like the sky, but you know it's the beach because the beach is darker than the sky right now.
That's right. Thank God for that, huh? Okay, so then what else? So what are our camping stories? Come stand right here by me. Okay. What are the camping stories? What's our favorite camping story? Did we do anything?
You telling us all the names that you think of.
Oh, yeah, that's right. So we would think of a name of somebody, and then I would draw a picture in my head about what that person would be from now until maybe when they die. And what was our favorite one?
I think the Travis.
Okay, so we came up with Travis, and you weren't sitting there. And so Travis is going to be a...
Marine.
He's going to be in the Marines, and he's going to marry a girl, because he's going to go overseas, and he's going to marry a girl named...
Tina.
No.
No. Was it like Lily? Was it Lily?
Tina. Yeah.
No,
it was
and,
Tina.
And they're gonna have a baby girl named Tina.
No, Timmy.
Okay, Timmy. That's right, a baby boy named Timmy. But this is all not what we usually do. All right. So what are our camping stories talked about
what
out? Okay, so what our favorite story was when we went to the beach with Mommy
and
Kelly, which is Mommy, and Brooke, which is your mommy. And what did we see? So we pulled up to the beach.
And we were, me, Brooke, and Travis, and Abigail were walking. And then all of a sudden, I see what I think was a seal. So I got a little bit closer, and then I realized it was a live seal.
It was a ginormous elephant. Are they called elephant seals?
Yeah.
I mean, this
we
guy
were
was
like,
huge.
Passing by, and then my mom's like, oh, there's like a big one. It did
a
big seal.
I thought he was a big piece, because there were lots of wood laying there. I thought he was wood, and I didn't pay attention to it.
I thought he was wood.
What did you think?
And then,
I also thought he was wood.
Yeah.
Really? Is that what we're going to do today?
And the funny part about him is how he's doing his, like, snoring.
Okay, so we walked to the other end of the beach, and we were really focused on these guys that were doing those big, what are they called? Windsurfing?
Kite surfing.
Kite surfing, windsurfing. One guy put out wings that looked ginormous, right? And he got on that thing, and he took off, and he was miles from the beach, right?
Yeah, he was, like, in the middle.
And when we watched him go up, he caught air, and he was, like, doing flips in the air, and he wasn't even on the water anymore. That was pretty cool.
And he landed every single shot.
And then there was another guy who was there, and he was going to do it, and he said that his kite wasn't big enough because there wasn't enough wind. Well, we all thought there was lots of wind, right? Because it was pretty windy down there.
It's probably because of the different
thing about it.
I need an
Auntie Brooke's
jacket.
Yeah. You what?
I need an Auntie Brooke's jacket.
Yeah, you had to. Yeah, because it was pretty cold. Yeah, so we walked over to the other side of the beach, and that's when you guys figured out that there was a, the elephant seal was there. And then we stood and we watched him, and we didn't think that he was alive, but he had lots of foam coming out of his mouth, right?
Nose.
It was his nose? Oh, his nose. And he has lots of whiskers, so he definitely needed a shave. And then he had... He had the really ruffly, he was doing that.
That's just that snoring.
Like, he had an elephant nose doing.
Oh, that's what I'm trying to say, is he had that little weird, stouty elephant nose. Yeah. And then we went over to the other side of the beach where we were heading when we saw him, and then we watched the waves come in, and my feet got all wet.
Yeah. When me and my mom were taking pictures, she got wet, but I didn't get wet at all.
Yeah, but we took a really cool picture on that big piece of cement.
Yeah, it looks like
it was part of a pier or something. It had a hole in it.
Like a sink, a toilet.
No, it was not a sink for sure, but it looked like it was a giant pier. I mean, toilet would be kind of
weird. And then on the way back to the car, we stopped to look at Bob, the elephant seal. And you could see him, like, his little nose going. And you also called him Bob while we were up there.
Yep, so you guys named the elephant seal Bob. And when you said goodbye to him, that's when he started to turn over.
No, that's when he opened his eyes.
Well, at first we thought he was dead because he wasn't moving. It had a big gash in his side, but it wasn't bloody or anything. It just looked like it was old. And then we were worried about who to call. And then we started to say goodbye. And then he opened his eyes. And what color was his eyes?
Red.
Red eyes, huh? He's probably super tired.
Our white is, like, he opened his eyes and it was red, but his eyes were black.
No, the outline was red.
Yeah, well, probably because he's super tired. It's rough to be out in the ocean. You ran? But there was a sign there that said what?
Beware of elephant seals.
And what else did it say? Don't get near them, don't pet them, and don't try to feed them because they're ginormous and they can
hurt
you.
And they can run very fast, yes. Faster than you think.
So if you're going to come here and you go to the beach, which again is right over there, you should look and see if you can see the seals, because somebody told us that there were some seals down on the other side on a cove, right?
Yeah.
And that you could probably see them. So if you're going to come here, you should probably check what time of year the seals are out if you want to see them. Right? Because they don't come out all the
we
time.
Can see I think if just Bob's there times. Next time you yeah. come on check out Abby's Bob. Birthday.
We didn't give the name of the beach we went to, though. We'll have to find out what that was.
Yeah. No,
it it's about 2 miles. So then we got in the car and we came back, and where else did we stop?
We stopped at the pie shop.
Uh-huh. Is it called the pie? I think it's called the Pie Ranch.
Yeah.
And it's about a quarter of a mile down south of where we are right now. And it's a pretty cool old barn, and they have lots of handmade things from people that live in the area.
And they have ice cream.
And they had super good ice cream. We had vanilla, and we brought scoops home in a cup, or back to the campground, and we ate them. And then we also got a lemon buttermilk pie, which was really good. But they
and then
had walnut.
Coffee pie.
I know they had a walnut. Oh, no, we got another thing called a galette, which was a little tiny tart made with some onions and potatoes. It was a potato galette. It was super good. So that was really fun, and we brought it back, and then we had made dinner, and here we are. So is there anything else that you want to talk about for our camping stories? Anything else that you would like to tell people about that we saw here that we did?
What? Beach.
We went to the
beach.
We were
literally just talking
about the beach.
Walkie-talkies. Walkie-talkies, yeah. We lost a lot of walkie-talkies.
Did you lose the walkie-talkies?
No, we only lost one, but then we found it.
Okay, but so that's one thing that we do when we go camping, and that's that we all have a walkie-talkie, right?
We go to the playground.
And why is that? Why do we always have walkie-talkies?
Because
we go to the playground, we ride our bikes without anyone with us.
And
parents can call us for dinner, lunch, or
breakfast.
Okay, but why? When we go places, when we ride our bikes, what is it we have to do?
Stick together. That's right. And we have the walkie-talkies just in case, like if we don't stick together and we can't find anybody or we get lost, we know.
That's right. Why is that so important? Because you just said it. Because in case you get lost, or somebody's getting near you that you don't trust, or something happens, like you get a flat tire on your bike or something, then you can tell us where you are and we can come and help you. Right?
Yep.
Okay, well, we can't see you if you got that on your head. Okay, so is there anything else you want to put in the book? Where's our next destination? Anybody know?
Beach!
We're going to Red Bluffs?
Wait, what?
Spring Break, Red Bluff KOA.
Red Bluff KOA and Spring Break, and that's when? End of August? A month from now?
Yeah.
End of April?
Yeah, we come back on Sunday.
Who's coming? Yes?
So we're coming back on Sunday, so then I have to unpack to pack again to go to camp again.
Oh, that's right, because you're going to school camp.
Yeah.
Okay. What?
For 3 days. On Tuesday.
Okay.
We're leaving on Monday.
We're leaving April 6th and it's called?
Red Bluff KOA.
Okay, so on April 6th, we're going to the Red Bluff KOA.
Yep.
And that'll be our next trip. All right. Okay, this was super fun. I would come here anytime, any place, right? This is
birthday.
I think so far this is my favorite campground ever. Okay, and you want to come for your birthday, but your birthday's on Easter, so we said no to that. All right, so let's all say goodbye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Thanks for watching.
So we're getting stuff to make sandwiches. So we need
Daddy
mayonnaise.
No.
We'll be right back.